Mind your decisions, I'm Presh Talwalkar. The square ABCD has a side length equal to 10. Suppose E is the midpoint of the side AD. Fold the square from the vertex A along the line segment EB in such a way that the point A becomes the point F. The question is, what is the distance from the point F to the line segment DC? I thank Ankit and Amlan for the suggestion. Pause the video if you'd like to give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching to learn how to solve this problem. There are many ways to solve this problem, and I will present three different methods. Let's get started by using similar triangles. First, since E is the midpoint of the side AD, we have that AE is equal to 5. Next, consider the right triangle AEB. We can calculate its hypotenuse EB using the Gogu theorem. EB is equal to the square root of 5 squared plus 10 squared, which means EB is equal to 5 times the square root of 5. Construct AF. Let its intersection with the line EB be the point G. Since E is equidistant from the points A and F, and B is equidistant from the points A and F, EB is the perpendicular bisector of AF. Consequently, these line segments are perpendicular. From here, triangle AGE must be similar to triangle BAE. These are both right triangles that share an equal angle. Therefore, we can equate the ratio of the hypotenuse to the longer side. This means EA over AG is equal to EB over BA. We substitute in the values, and then we solve for AG. We simplify to get AG is equal to 10 divided by the square root of 5. Now, what's the length of GF? Well, AG and GF are equal to each other because EB is the perpendicular bisector of AF. Therefore, GF is equal to 10 divided by the square root of 5. Now, let's construct FH. This creates another right triangle, and it shares an angle with the right triangle AGE. Therefore, AHF is similar to the right triangle AGE. But from before, AGE is similar to the right triangle BAE. Therefore, AHF is similar to the triangle BAE. This means we have the following ratios that are equal. From here, we substitute in the known values, and we can simplify and solve for AH. We get that AH is exactly equal to 8. Now AD, the entire side of the square, is equal to 10. AH plus HD must be equal to 10, and this means HD is equal to 2. But HD is exactly equal to the distance from F to the line segment DC. Therefore, the distance from F to the line segment DC is equal to 2, and that's our answer. Let's now move to the next method of using coordinate geometry. We will first set up a coordinate system. We'll run the x-axis through the bottom side of the square, and we'll run the y-axis through the left side of the square. We can then describe the coordinates of some of these points. The upper corner of the square will be equal to 10, 10, because each side of the square has a length equal to 10. Let's now describe the equation for a line that passes through these two points. Notice that the line that passes through these two points will have a slope equal to 1/2, and we already know that the y-intercept is equal to 5. Therefore, we have the equation 1/2 x plus 5. We then want to describe the equation of the line that goes through the points 0, 10, and f. Notice that since these two lines are perpendicular, the slope of this line will be the negative reciprocal of the first line. So the slope of this line will be equal to negative 2, and we know its y-intercept is equal to 10. So this line will have an equation that's equal to negative 2x plus 10. To find the intersection of these two lines, we set the equations equal to each other, and we can readily solve that x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 6. Now this point will exactly be the midpoint between 0, 10, and F. Suppose F has the coordinates of P and Q. We thus have 10 plus Q all over 2 is equal to 6. This means Q is equal to 2. And that's exactly the vertical distance. Therefore, the distance from F to the line segment DC is equal to 2. We'll now move on to the third method of trigonometry. To get started, recall that the hypotenuse EB has a length equal to 5 times the square root of 5. Then, triangle AEB is congruent to triangle FEB. This means FB has a side length equal to 10. From here, suppose angle ABE is equal to theta. That means angle EBF is also equal to theta. Now, construct FP that's perpendicular to the side AB. Consider this triangle. The sine of 2 theta will be equal to FP divided by 10. We can then use the sine double angle formula. From here, we need to calculate the sine of theta and the cosine of theta, which we can readily get from the triangle ABE. We calculate the values for sine of theta and cosine of theta and substitute those into the formula. We then simplify and we will solve that FP is equal to 8. Now, FP is equal to 8. But the entire vertical distance is equal to the side of the square. Consequently, the distance from F to the side DC is equal to 2, just as before. It's a very interesting problem that you can solve in many different ways. Thanks for making Mind Your Decisions one of the best channels on YouTube. As always, thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.